Greetings everyone. So today we're going to talk about the constraint. Constraint is a relation between two objects, and it must be two objects in the scene to make a relation between them and to make a constraint. And let's see that we have a cube, and we have another object which is maybe this monkey and moving this to be here. So we will talk about the most important constraint inside the Blender, and you should use them in your project. So we will make a constraint from this tab and add object constraint. It's this icon, which is similar to the modifier of course, and let's make it a child of, and we will make a child of the monkey. And as you can see, it's an this influence is the strength of this constraint, and if you move this, you will see that the cube is following this, and you can set inverse to make the Sudan monkey. And I think let's set inverse to make the cube following this one. And if we follow again, so let's make the strength to be 1 and moving it to be here. So this is the relation of the concept of the object constraint. And also, if you make any simple animation, let's go from here to make it location, and after 50 frame we will move it to here and insert a location, and let's go back and play. So as you can see, it's following such as this. So let's clear all of these objects and start a new file, and we will make a cube, and let's again make another cylinder, and this cylinder will be here, and let's move from this point to be here, and let's add another constraint. So we will choose the track 2, and we will choose the cylinder, we will choose minus z to make it a track. So if we move this cube, as you can see, g and y, it's pointing to this cylinder, g and x, it's pointing to this cylinder. So this is very very helpful if you use this as camera object, and we will make an example for this in using the camera. So this is a very useful feature of course, and you can choose here the influence, and you can choose the world to be local. So let's talk about something helpful, which is the constraint of using the cube transform. So let's imagine that you have here, let's first choose the surface and going to the vertex group and assign this to be vertex. Then we will make another UV sphere, and let's scale it down and move into the axis, and assume that this is a button, and let's extrude scale this one, and extrude such as this, and assume this is a button. So we will make some loop cut here, and you want to this button to be sticked on this surface. So we will choose this one and going to the object constraint, and choose copy transform, and make it to be in the cylinder, and the vertex group to be the group. So it's following this option, but let's apply all the rotation and the scale. So it's fine to be here, and its object or origin must be here. So we can disable again and choose the surface, which is below here, and shift is cursor selected, and let's make the origin to be the 3D cursor. And let's activate it again, and if you scale the surface, as you can see, it must, let's go here, and let's apply here also rotation and scale, and if we scale it, if we rotate, it's following. If we if we move in the z-axis, so it's moving. If we move in the y-axis, it's moving. If we rotate, so it's moving such as this. So this is the most useful feature that you should use in an project and this is very, very useful for you. So I hope you enjoy this tutorial. See you in the next lesson.